Assalamu alaikum. Myself, Maryam Ali. Today I'm going to explain you how to implement half adder and the half subtractor and how to implement full adder and the full subtractor. So basically, these implementations are by using the basic logic gates instead of using the ICs, or we can say that we are going to study what inside the ICs of these full adder and the half adder subtractor. So now before going to their implementation, let's get what are these adder and subtractor and where these adder and subtractor use. As defined by their names, adder and the subtractor, these are just like the basic addition and subtraction as we do in the mathematics. The only difference is that we did there as a decimal and we are going to perform here as a binary number. And further, where these use? So these are used in the arithmetic logic units, at that these adder, subtractor, or other like multiplier, divisors, and other logical operators like shift, true, false. So all contained in this arithmetic logic units inside it. And these are logic units are used in the process where logic units and arithmetic units are needed. So first of all, what is half adder? Just let it get by their name, adder. What is adder? Adder is the basic addition we are going to study today. As in the mathematics, we do the addition like 1 plus 1 is equal to 2. But here, in the binary, we are going to study 1 plus 1 is equal to 1, 0, or 0 plus 1 is equal to 1. So things like that. Here, or we can say the 1 plus 1 plus 1 is equal to 3. But in the binary, we are going to study 1 plus 1 plus 1 is equal to 1, 1. So how this goes, we are going to study today. So basically today we are studying about the addition and subtraction also, and these are the 2-bit addition and subtractor. Every addition contains some carry inside it, so we are studying that today. Now first let's get to this block diagram here. So this is a block diagram. These are the two inputs here and there is output here. This is a sum and this is the carry. A plus B is a sum here and the carry of it is here. So what inside this block we're going to get to know by implementing some input here and getting some output here, and then we implement this circuit here by using the truth table. So basically, if we as there are two binary inputs, so 2-bit. So as input here, let's add it. 0 plus 0 is 0. So the sum is 0, and as a single 0, so there is no carry inside it. The other is 0 plus 1. 0 plus 1 is 1, so there is no carry here too. Other 1 plus 0, also there is no carry. The other is the 1 plus 1. Why its sum is 0 and it is 1? Let's get to know it. 1 plus 1. Like that. So 1 plus 1 is 10. As 2 in the decimal is 2 in decimal and the binary is 10. So here the right here is as a carry and this is the sum. So that is the sum and that is the carry here. So this is how this half adder implementation contain? So basically, if we look this thing, the sum here, this represent the XOR gate. It is defined by a plus sign and circle it. And this here is a carry. Let's get to know how this carry thing form. As here, we studied before how to form the max terms 0, 1. So for the 0, A bar, and for the B, B. Other is A and B bar. And other are 0, so we are not going to take those inside the max terms. And they form A bar B plus A B bar. And this whole thing is represented as this XOR thing. That is A plus and B. This is how this thing forms. And their circuit is, we also define this circuit here. Let's get to near the circuit today on the Proteus implementation. As we see that the A plus B contains the XOR, and this is the XOR, and this contains the AND. Let's run it. Yeah, let's start it. As we say, 1 plus 1 is sum at 0 and the 1. So 1 plus 1 like that. If we contain 1 0, then 1 0, sum is 1, carry is 0. Sum is 1, carry is 0. Similarly like that, 0 1, sum is 1 and the carry is 0. And the LED is on, it represents 1. When an LED is off, it represents 0. So now, this is the half adder that we studied, but what is this? This is the half adder just by using the NAND gate only. We are not going to use any other gate here. So how we implement this circuit? If we took equations from this circuit, and then we apply De Morgan's law and the other functions, or we can say other logical functions, then we get this thing. This here. This is the logic implementation AB here, and this here. This is the sum, this is the carry, and we implement it on the and form a NAND gate by it. Let's get what is the this NAND gate work similarly like that. Both are giving same input. Let's check them in the comparison. 1 1 here, 1 1 the carry is 1, so at both 0, at both 0 the LED is off, that at both 0, 0 plus 0 is 0, no carry, no sum. Let's get to the full adder. So what is the full adder? Let's get the full adder. In the half adder, we are not going to implement any carry inside it. But if we add a carry here, Cn, then this represents as a full adder. So basically, the full adder is just like that we are adding here. And then let's just get this. This is A and this is B here. So that's why we say that it is a full subtractor, and this is the half subtractor here. So let's study it, how this Cout and some work of this full adder. So basically, first of all, we had to add A plus A, and this sum gets here and this here. So basically, A plus B. A plus B is 0, and then we add carry inside it and we get 0 2. So the both sum and the carry out is null, so the 0. Let's study some thing like that here. This thing 0 1 0. So 0 plus 1 is 1. And if we add 1 plus 0, then also 1. So the sum is 1 and the carry is null. Similarly, if we get to the second last one thing, here 1 plus 1. The 1 plus 1 is 1 plus 1. As we studied before, it is 1, 0 in the decimal. So this 1 here is the carry, and we get carry here. Carry out is this, and this 0 is the sum here. The other thing is 1 plus 1 plus 1. So first of all, we have to do 1 plus 1. So 1 plus 1. This is 10 here. And now this 10 is going to add in this, 1, 0, not 10, as it is a binary. So we are not going to represent it as 10, it is 1, 0, that represent 2. This here. In the arithmetic logic units, we going to add, subtract, or anything. We are going to do it by bitwise thing. So first bit here, 0 plus 1, 1. Second bit, exactly here, so 1. So now this is the carry, this is the carry, this is the sum. So the sum here and the C out here. This is how this implement. As before, we are studying for the 2-bit here, it is for the 3-bit here. Now let's implement it on the Proteus and check it. This is how I implement it on the Proteus, as just by form their equations, as we do like this equation is here, A bar, B bar, C in, as it is. Now the next thing was one at this, then it is A bar, B and a C in bar. So now zeros ignore it. Now that's this term. This term is A, B bar, C in. This is how this form, and let's get their circuit and we implement it like that. Let me show you full adder by using this. So this is how the full adder work. This is A XOR, B XOR, C, and this is the C out. This is a full adder implementation. Now for the NAND implementation, we go through some functions, apply some function, and get these equations here. So let's get to the circuits board and check them equally. Check it. This is, we run the circuit here. So for, let's check it for the, for this one, 001, A is 0, B is 0, and C in is 1. The sum is 1 and the carry is 0. Let's check here. If both are same, then our circuit implementation is exactly right. 0, 0, like that. The sum is 1 and the carry is 0. For the triple 1, 1, 1, 1. For the all 1, 4, here 2. For the 1, the 1. This is for the triple 1. Sum is 1, carry is 1, sum is 1, carry is 1. This is how the circuit implement, and that is exactly right here. So we are verifying the circuits today also. So these both are same and work exactly the same. So we verified it. Now the next thing is subtractor. In the adder, we say this is the sum and this is the carry. But here in the subtraction, we don't say it like this is sum or this is for the A minus B. We say this is the difference, and for the borrow, we say this is the borrow. So let me tell you what I am saying here is, like, if we have 91 minus 1, I'm going to show you the, let me get here, 91 and 1 minus, or sorry, if we get to 0, get a borrow 1 now. So it is 8 and this is 10. So now 10. Now this thing we do it here is called the borrow thing. That how that what we are going to study, the borrow and the difference. Let me tell you by using the truth table. 0 minus 0. So the 0 minus 0, the difference is 0, no borrow. 0 minus 1. So now there is a problem here. That 1 is bigger and 0 is small. So the negative sign is with the 1 here. So we can implement it like that here. This. Now for that we have to borrow a 1 here. So we borrow 1 and we wrote here. So this then in the decimal represent 2 and 1 represent 1. So 2 minus 1 is 1. So similarly this is 1 here and we get difference is 1. The other things are simple as there is no bigger, no small. 1 minus 0 is 1, no borrow. 1 minus 1 is 0, so no borrow. Let's implement it on the, here is the half adder. This is the half subtractor here. So this is the half subtractor here and let me run it to check it. This is here is the half subtractor using the NAND gate also. Let me get to what is half. So this is the half subtractor here and we run it. We run the simulation and let's check this by comparing thing into the NAND gate. Let's get how this NAND gate comes here. NAND gate equation. So for the half subtractor here, the NAND equation. The difference is here the similar XOR here and this is the borrow thing is different here. Like in that half adder we are using AB only. So in this is A bar B. So we are for the bar we are using the NOT gate here. And the other this thing also this whole process is just work under how to form a NAND gate. Just implement things here and till end the or we can say till end this simplification when no plus sign left here. So that we don't have to add a or we only have to implement a NAND gate circuit here. So let's check it in the difference here. So we check verified it works properly or not at both 0 like 0 minus 0. So the difference and the borrow both are 0. If A is 1 and the B is 0, A is 1 and the B is 0. So that is how both difference and the borrow are 1 1. So for the both one the difference in the borrow is 0 because 1 minus 1 is 0. If we implement also that thing 1 minus 0. 1 minus 0 is 1. So difference is 1 and no borrow. As the 1 is greater, so there is no borrow here. This is how this works. Let's get to our last circuit today, that is full subtractor. So what is full subtractor? As here we define in the full adder that how these two half adder connected and get a full adder. Similarly this is like how a half add subtractor come and join here like AB. Now the is representation get A here. The borrowing comes here, the borrowing carry out here, and the B in come here. That we can see also that this borrowing in is B. And then this AB get a difference here, and this borrowing gets here, and this is the R adding them, and we get a borrower add here. Let's get it, sir. This is the most complicated thing in the whole we studied today. So let's get here, like A minus B is 0 equal to 0. So 0 minus 0 is 0. And so this is D0 and this is borrowing out here. Now the next thing is 0 minus 0, 0. It is now. Now this is 0 minus 1. For 0 minus 1, we studied before properly that how to borrow 1 and this 10 represent 2, the 2. So 2 minus 1 is 1 here. So borrowing out is 1, carrying out is 1 here. Let's get to our last complicated. Other things are just work like 0, 1 is 1, 1, 0, 0 is 0, 0, and further the 1 goes to. Let's get it. 1 minus 1 is 0. And answer is 0 minus 1. So the 0 minus 1 is that here. 0 minus 1 is borrowing is 1. The borrowing is 1 here. And the sum, not the sum, the difference is 1 also. This is how this thing works. The only complicated thing is that we have to learn that if we get a higher digit, we have to take a borrow here and we have to do the subtraction before it. Like for the 10, it is okay. For the 00, it is okay. For the 11, it is okay for the subtraction. But for the 01, this is not okay because 1 is larger and the 0 is smaller. And is in decimal math, we also know that if we took a number like 90 minus 1, then here if we do it like bit, then this is 01. That 01 is not suitable. We have to take a carry 8 and a 1 here. So this is how this thing works here. Now what is the NAND that we basically using in the whole circuit like that? Using NAND gates. So let me get you what is NAND gate actually. The NAND gate is true only when both are 00 here. So that's how this works. Now let me get you at the last full subtractor by using the NAND gate here. So this B represents the borrowing here, D here. This equation forms just like that as I told you before. Like how to form an equation from a circuit. These are just max terms I was studying in the lab before. Like here, the 0 represent as a bar and the other thing 1 as a simple one, and just multiply, take a dot of it, and then the thing here is get a add of it. So this is how we get this equation here. The other thing is here is the borrowing out carry. Another thing is just implementing just the last thing here before. We are not using any. We have to, I told you before that we have to implement the circuit till no plus or any other sign is represented, just the AND gate and just the R, as this is the NAND gate here that contain a small O thing, a bubble here, which represent the NOT gate. Actually, this is like that here. This is AND gate, which represent AB. And if we get a NOT with it, so it is represent a bar. Let me get you implemented on the circuit here, what I am saying. This is the AND, and this is the NOT thing here. So this whole thing forms this circuit here. This is the vertical, the bubble here represent this NOT gate here. This is I am saying that we have to implement it like that. Now let's check this circuit here to verify that the both full subtractor and the full subtractor using NAND gate are similar. Now let's check this here. 0 0 0 and all are 0, that the all LED must be off like that. Here if we do all LED off, all LED are off, then the difference and the boring out are 0. Let's check this. 0 1 1, boring is 1 0 and the 1. The 0 1 1, the boring out is 1, the difference is 0. Similarly like that here. Like that, the boring out is 1 only. As 0 1 1, the boring out is 1 only. 1 1 0. Let's study this. 1 1 and the 0. 1 1 and the 0. So the no difference, no boring out. Cause let me get you study the last thing, that how this work if we don't understand it. 1 1 and 0. 1 minus 1 is 0. So if we get it, if we get difference it with the bin, it is also 0. So the condition is 0 0. Now check it for the last one, when all are 1. All are 1. So the 1 1 1, the difference is 1. So this is how this work. In the today, for an overview, we get to know about what is half adder and half subtractor, how the input of both adder A plus B goes into the sum, and that sum combined with a carry out or with a bin to get a full adder and the full subtractor. So today we implement this half adder and subtractor, half full adder and the full subtractor, also by using the NAND gates too, and we verify that both circuit results are same. We also get to know about the half adder and the full adder in the also addition and subtraction of the binary. Hope so you understand the today lab. Thank you.